minutes. I wanted to tell you about basket weaving because it's one of the oldest art forms there are. And it actually predates ceramics, they believe. And actually they, primitive peoples or earlier peoples, not primitive, would use baskets to actually mold their clay vases up in. You can see the pattern of the baskets in some of the really, really, really early baskets. And weaving is one of the most meditative things you learn to do. And once you learn to do something like this, the world of weaving can open up to you. And it's just amazing. You can weave anything. You can weave almost anything. It's just a beautiful art. And I've made some big baskets and small baskets, and they're not that hard. So the instructions look very intense, but once you see it, I think it's going to work a lot better. There's also some a lot of videos on YouTube if for some reason the way I explain it doesn't work. So let's see a little bit more about baskets. Oh, about caning. So this looks like such a perfect, you know, looks like it's been through a machine, but it generally has not been through a machine. There is a vine that's a thorny cactus that's in Southeast Asia, Australia, Fiji, and it grows up to the top of the rainforest or the forest, and people will go in and pull them out of the forest. Whole families will go in for an entire week, pull all the caning out, and then they'll clean it. And there's thorns at some different junctures, and they'll take the thorns off. And then sometimes some cane, you have to actually take the bark off. But that's really what they do, and they process it. If you get into this more, you can walk around your yard. You can find wisteria. You can carve off bark, you know, and the trick is to soak it or do it green. Some people do baskets green because they're going to dry about 30-40% and they get really tight. So, baskets, I just found a quote that baskets were in the ancient Mesopotamians were considered the children of God, of the gods, and the basis of our earth, and that somebody floated a basket on the water that had earth on it. So it kind of coincides with the Native American view of where the earth started with the 13th turtle going down and bringing dirt up to the surface. So that's how land formed. Some of this, if you go to New Mexico, there's still such stunning basket weaving art. And some of it can be so fine and tight that it makes like you can make a spoon and make it watertight, waterproof. Oh, okay. It's that awesome. So, all right. So the first thing we're going to do here is, and I'm going to have to keep checking my instructions because I do it different every time and I want to do it the same as I read it. So we're going to take out one reed. You can see I have mine. Show over here
24 inches
just long. Soaking in a great big plastic container, and sometimes I'll keep it in there for days. After about 2 weeks it will begin to mold. So okay, sorry. I'm back, yay. Technical difficulties. Okay. So we're going to take just one read at it, and you'll know it does tend to kind of tangle up, but it untangles pretty easily. It doesn't, not like a hose that knots. So we're going to cut 8 pieces that are 24 inches long. And I just use my kitchen shears, but usually scissors will work. I have a little bit of a thinner cane than you do. Just by circumstance, I ordered a test lot. It's a little bit too thin, but I'm going to use it. So go ahead and cut your 8.
We take it out of the water then?
Yeah, take it out of the water. And I think we can work with it that way. You might want to, after you cut them, well, no, we'll see if it works. It should work. It's pretty thin.
Just take one out.
Huh?
Take one out. One.
Take one long one out, just like I did. And they're all different lengths. And then you're going to cut it into, you're going to make 8 pieces that are each 24 inches long.
Oh,
2, 4, 6. Yeah, we'll have to thank Roxana, who she weighed out all of this, because you can't really just count out canes because they're all different lengths. So she weighed everybody's. So that was pretty impressive. 2, 4, 7. Get one more out. You guys just stop and I don't always see everybody on screen at one time. So stop and or just yell at me if you have any questions.
Yeah, I'm still trying to pull out one piece. It's
not going as fast as you are.
Okay. I'll wait. Yep, I'll wait.
We're working on it.
Yeah.
And there's two of us and we're slow, so. But we're beginners.
I will wait till everyone has their 8 pieces cut.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Yes, absolutely. And those of you who got them cut, you could probably just put them back in the water for a minute while we.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
In fact, during your basket weaving, sometimes, especially in summer in Austin, they'll dry out a little bit. And you really want to keep them wet because they don't crack and break. And also, they will shrink and tighten up the basket when the basket dries. So that's a good thing. Good thing to do.
Oh, I have to entangle it right now. Yeah. Keep the remaining pieces all soaked. Okay. So now you said how many pieces to make out of this?
8 pieces that are 2 feet long, 24 inches long.
24 inches, 8, okay.
Yeah.
This is kind of funny. I feel meditative already.
Okay.
Are you counting?
No, I didn't count. They got to stop and count. Hang on.
I like the history, Barbara. You know, I always like things put in historical context, and that was great.
Yeah, and it's something in particular women have been doing forever. Oh. And women have been, you know, because of that, there's some amazing artistry around baskets.
Okay, we're done. Yeah, I started like when I travel a little collection. I only have 2 so far. I've got one in South Carolina, sawgrass basket.
Oh, nice.
And then we went to Alaska and I got a little basket. They do this whale, I can't remember what they call it, but the top of the whale.
Baleen.
Yeah. But they were too expensive. Ooh. But if I go back, I might get one, because after I didn't get one, I thought, why am I being so cheap? But but they do some, you know, wherever you go, people use, like you were saying, their native materials and they make baskets.
Right, and it supports, you know, it supports more like villages in the rainforest without, destroy the rainforest. That's one good thing about it. There, sometimes in the old days, they used to boil it in kerosene. I don't think they do it anymore, but that was the only negative thing I had ever read about it, but. But I have 2 baskets, 2 big giant baskets that are, so you've got lots of different cane. You've got round cane and you've got half round cane. Half round is usually, they've cut off the bark edge of a wider piece of round cane. And so you have one flat side and one round that's shinier. Anyway, I have some baskets that I've had literally since 1973 that I still have that are in perfect condition that I use for everything. They're big, whereas I've probably gone through 10 plastic baskets in my life, and I've never used my plastic bag in a basket again. It's amazing.
I made a mistake. I cut only 12 inches.
Ooh, look at that. That is beautiful. Wow. Where's that from? Deborah, I can't hear you. Unmute.
I'm helping. Here. Oh,
yes.
Sorry.
I bought it at a quilt show, but it's from Africa.
It's beautiful.
Yeah. Beautiful. Yeah. It's gorgeous.
Look at mine.
All right. So, Kenny, are you ready?
No, almost.
Almost, okay. Just tell me when. Everybody else ready?
I went and made a mistake. But now I think I'm almost there.
Oh, yeah. We have plenty of reeds, so we can make plenty of mistakes.
Here's my elephant ear sawgrass. Can you see it? I can't see me. Can you see it?
Oh, look at that. That is awesome.
Yeah.
I have no idea how they did that.
Alaskan. I cannot remember what it's just grass, whatever their grass is, but it's so pretty decorated.
Those are wonderful.
And then I got a big one I got at a store one time that I've been using for years. I don't know what it was. I got it at a
my favorite of
the Horchow outlet. Remember that Horchow?
Oh yeah. My favorite baskets are the pine needle baskets, which I can't imagine how much patience that takes. I don't think I'm going to try that one.
So anyway, when I travel in there, I get these little things so you can bring them back. They're not heavy. So it is a good thing. I try and have a souvenir that I'll appreciate.
And support the local economy, yeah.
Yeah, and support the local economy.
Okay.
If people can get... the Passport PBS channel, the public television channel, and they've got the Crafts in America is one of the shows they have.
Yeah.
And they've got a couple which are on baskets, which are just astounding.
I have not ever seen that. That's a great reminder. It's been on my bucket list for about years.
It's worth seeing.
I got the 8 pieces now.
Want to push it out of. Oh, you can hardly see me. I'm too light lit. I should put that down.
Candy, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay now.
Okay. Pieces, yes. All right.
Wearing my apron, I'm a hot mess.
So what we're gonna do is divide yours into two piles of four.
Two piles of four, Phil.
These are called the spokes. Now this is the part that you might want to watch carefully. Once you get your base done, this is the hardest part to do. And once you get it done, everything else after that is just easy. So we're going to, Lori, you want to do the close up? Or you have it on that already?
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that four?
Yeah. Okay. So we're going to cross our four and four, and I'm just holding them with my thumb. That's all there is right there.
Four and four. Okay.
Yeah. All right. You're going to take, and I'm sorry, I should have gotten you to do this first. Take another strand, and you might have to disentangle it. So go ahead and get another strand ready. If you have to put this down.
How long is the strand?
Just take the long. Just take any one of them, and we're going to start with what's in there. We won't need to cut any more. So we'll use whatever we have, the length that it already exists in. So.
You don't have to cut it?
Huh?
You don't have to cut the.
No, we won't cut it anymore. Not yet. Not till the very end. We'll do some trimming. But all right. So at this point, I'm going to lay, get a little closer, my new piece against one of the sets of spokes. And I'm just going to hold it.
Okay.
Now, this is the tricky part. We're going to go over and under the four spokes three times around. And it's a little hard you can watch a second. You just want to keep holding it together. It feels very awkward in the beginning. So I went under and over.
And under. First.
And I keep holding it. And I'll probably need to turn it and switch hands. Don't worry about your little piece that's sticking out the end piece.
Am I leaving it?
Over, under, over, around in a circle. I think you need it with a longer piece.
Hang on, we gotta, oh. Huh.
And you keep all of those very close to the spoke?
As close as you can get, yeah.
Close as you can get them, okay.
Now as you're going around, this is the terms called lashing. This is where you're gonna make your base.
Lashing.
And all we're doing right now is kind of holding it together the best we can. Because you'll notice, if you weave around an even number of spokes, you're not really getting a weave. It's going under the same ones every time and over the same ones every time.
Ah.
Not really.
You need help?
Can you do this four times around?
Just three times.
Okay.
Yeah. Start over.
Does it go around in the round in a circle or kind of around?
Over, yeah. Over, under, what you're doing.
Under, over. Yes.
Yeah. You're going in a circle and you'll go under, over, and you'll be going under, over the same set of spokes every time until you get three on there.
Under.
And let's see. That's what we got.
Wow.
Yeah.
Glad you're here. I'd never be able to do this. I'm so uncoordinated. Okay. You didn't say when you start out, you got to be coordinated.
Yeah, there's a lot of ways to start this basket, but this works pretty well. So,
you know, do you want to pull it tight when you start it at the beginning, or doesn't matter?
Say that again.
You need to pull it tight.
As tight as you can, yeah. And you can count on that it's going to shrink a little bit. And you also can count on that as you get a feel of this, it gets better.
Since mine is not soaked, it's very hard.
Is it too stiff?
Yeah, because right. It's not soaked yet.
But do you want to just put it back in the water and then watch this time?
Yeah.
Okay.
How many times? Three or four?
Three. Yeah. So here
that is not
okay. Great. And I guess you're going to tell us how to tie off.
We're not going to tie off for a long time. We're not going to tie off.
Okay, so you just leave it that way.
Yeah, till the very end.
Sorry.
Okay. No. Good question, actually.
I think I'm doing this wrong.
What do you think? Let me get
You gotta go.
Gallery view. Okay, show me who thinks they're doing it wrong. No, you're good. Let's see.
Okay.
Wait. No, you don't want to divide your spokes yet. You have four. You just have two across two right now. We're going to divide them next step. So you only have
it's, just the four.
Yeah, you just got four across four. That's all we're doing.
Okay.
And that is going to just give us a start.
Okay.
Well, I'm sorry. I'm hanging on to it. That's why.
Let me try
Should the piece that you're using to weave it around, is the beginning of that piece very short, or did you leave the beginning of it long?
It's sticking out. Let's get this view. It's sticking out right there. This piece, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. So yeah. It's very short, quite
it's
short.
It's very short, yeah. And don't worry about that. We can, we'll trim it or whatever, tuck it. A lot of times you just tuck them in later. That's kind of the easiest way to do. And this one will disappear into the spokes. The spokes will be pretty much covered by the time we're done.
Yeah, we can be kind of like nice.
Oh yeah. So we've got a long side and a short side.
So Katie, put just keep it in your water as long as possible. And then at some point, maybe in 10 minutes, check again.
Okay, because it's not helping me. Yeah.
Okay.
It's not very pliable.
Yeah, okay. All right. Okay, has everybody got that part?
Yep.
Almost.
Almost, okay.
You need your glass to shut the
door. So, and I'll talk about the spokes a little bit. A lot of basket weaving that you will do, you will use different size spokes. So this is a size, you have a size 3 cane. I have a size 2, which is thinner. And instead of doubling them up like I do, you use just a single wider spoke, a much thicker spoke. You just need them to be stronger than what you're pulling. This is, you're going to keep pulling against it, and they either need to be doubled or they need to be a stronger reed. So if you go to buy reed, you might want to buy a roll of 3 and then a roll of 5. And there's some good web, you can look fine on the websites of what sizes you want. You can also use sticks to start, some really organic tree branches to do this, if particularly if they're green, makes it so much easier to work with their green.
Yeah.
I've soaked older branches. They don't really soften up very much if they're thick. So.
You want me to get more water?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay, so are we ready?
That's probably okay.
Yeah, maybe. Phil, you watch them get more water.
Okay.
So at this point, we have to make an odd number. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut off 2 spokes. I'm just cutting them off. There are some other ways to do If you have, particularly if these folks are bigger, you can actually just insert another one. A lot of that depends on how big you're going to go in your basket. We're not going that big. So we, when we, you know, as we grow up, they spread out more and more from each other. It won't be an issue with this. I'll explain that later when we get there. I guess it's coming.
Cut off two on one of the four.
Exactly.
Limbs. Okay.
And now we're going to, after you do that, we're going to spread everything into twos. Each spoke.
Now, where did you cut?
Any place. Just cut two off that are next to each other.
Just two off.
Yeah.
Just kind of toward the bottom.
Yeah. I cut it. There's probably a quarter inch there.
Okay.
Half inch is fine.
Half inch.
Yeah. And then one. And this is where the fun part starts. For some reason, I'm going counterclockwise. I have no idea. My right and left kind of go, they're kind of equally dominant. So, all right. So as soon as you're ready, you're going to take your long spoke, and now you're going to start going over and under.
And so how many are you going over each time and under?
You're going over two. So we're going to now, each spoke is going to be made of two strands instead of one thick one.
Your spoke is the one
over and under
in the middle three times.
You went?
Your spoke is the one that you ran around the middle.
Yes. I'm sorry. No, the spokes are the supports. These are actually called, there's a weird word. I think it's called the poles or well, not the poles.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, I call it the weave. Actually, the weaver. That's what it is. These are the weavers. So we've got a weaver now. And you're going to keep turning it in your hand. And we're going to go over and under and make sure now you're just doing every group of two. And you kind of gently spread them with your fingers so that they start evening out these spokes.
Let's see what she's doing.
And you'll start to notice as you go around and pull kind of tight.
I'm getting a bottom.
Yeah.
We'll go around two times and we'll stop a second. Pull them kind of tight, but you'll start noticing you are actually going over and under on opposite ones. So you actually are truly weaving.
See, it went under on this one.
Oh yeah.
First time, now we're going.
Yeah, and you'll make a mistake and you'll realize, oh, that didn't work. Okay, so after you get two or three on, let's stop. Has everybody got that so far?
Yes.
Okay.
Philip's doing it. See, I told you, he's good at this stuff.
He's good, yeah. Awesome.
Uh-oh, we're out of our weaver.
Yeah, our weaver is getting short.
Yeah. Okay, we're gonna go to your weaver has got about an inch left. Yeah.
Wow, we got about three.
You're close, all right. When you get to that point, you're going to get out another, I'll show you right now, another strand, another weaver.
Got to get another strand. Hang on, Phil. I'll get it. I've got to be doing something here.
It's a 2 week cut off.
And we want a long one, right?
Yeah, they don't just come out.
Well, you know what?
You've got to run them through backwards.
I'm going to get rid of this thing. It's a hassle.
Now, has everybody gone around two or three times with this? Let's see, we should have seven now instead of eight. Eight spokes. So you'll look at your piece and you can just kind of work them around to where they're a little bit more balanced. You know, since we cut one off, you'll just kind of work them around so they're evenly balanced around the whole piece.
Oh.
The spokes. So it doesn't look quite so wonky. And that happens pretty fast. Then after that, you can just keep going. And you'll notice, like I just did now, I all of a sudden, oops, I'm going over the same one twice so that I've made a mistake. So I'll undo it to make sure I'm doing the opposite every time, over and then under. And we're going to just keep it flat like a plate.
How long should the, it'll be easier to deal with.
Okay, so when you run out of your weaver, I've got a ways to go. So if you run out of your weaver, you're going to take your old end and you're just going to tuck it down in. And you're going to tuck your new one in right next to it. And you're just kind of invisibly tucking it in between two spokes.
Okay.
So you want to weave your old end enough left to weave it in. And don't worry if it sticks out right now. We can, in fact, you should probably leave maybe three inches, because we can trim that off later. Okay, is everybody good so far?
Yeah. Oh, we need
time. We tuck in the new, if we need a longer weaver, we just kind of tuck it in, you say?
Just feed it right in, and there's no magic trick to it at all. Okay. You just kind of tie it against another one, and it gets invisible pretty fast.
Yeah.
It's kind of okay, like, so at this point,
I'm going to take a crochet needle and stick them all in.
At this point is where your artistic design comes in. So you can have a basket that's round. You can have a basket that closes close to the top, almost like a bottle. You can have a basket that's big and low and wide. So you'll have to make a choice of what you want to do. I'm just going to do kind of a generic form. So if you want a big flat bottom, you're going to say, just keep going flat without pulling your spokes forward.
Your spokes give it the shape. Interesting.
I'm going to do that a little bit longer, and then I'll show you when you go around a little later. We're going to pull in a little bit to make the sides of the basket.
That's very flat. That's looking kind of.
You want it to be flat. That's what she's doing.
Yeah, this just makes it. If you want to do an art piece, no. But this just makes it so it can sit down on a table.
Yeah, that's what I want.
Yeah. Now, some of the baskets you'll see, you can buy wooden bases for them, and they have holes drilled, or you can make one, and you put your spokes in the holes, and it makes a really nice basket, too, to do that.
I like this.
So I'm going to go around until I finish this weaver, and I will show you what I'm going to do with the weaver.
So I better start pulling another one out.
Yeah, start pulling another one out.
Since I'm not doing much. Since I'm the helper, I better help, huh?
Good thing to do outside too, because then you can just kind of scatter all the weavers on the grass.
Except this one's tangled. I see the problem here.
Yeah, you've got to like, there it is, hard. Can we cut that wire? Get rid of that wire.
Yeah. But that's a pretty long piece. So.
Yeah,
generally they're pretty long. Every now and then you'll find a short one, but. And as you go around, you just keep evening out the distance between your spokes if they look a little bit off.
Yeah, mine do.
Yeah. All right.
I'm doing klutzy work.
All right, so now I'm gonna show you close up. I have this piece left that's about 3 inches here. Am I good, Gloria? Okay. And I'm gonna bend it, and I'm gonna tuck it down in between some spokes. Now you can tuck it down all the way through. It's a little hard, but you can also just tuck it down 2 or 3 spokes.
That's the weaver.
I might need a tool to do this one. I wove it pretty tight.
I wasn't hearing.
And have it stick out the back right here. And we'll trim it off later.
All right. There it is.
Very nice.
I'm going to feed in my next weaver.
Yeah.
On the kitchen floor.
How long should that be? Pretty long?
Huh?
Should the next weaver be pretty long?
Leave them as long as they can be. It's so much easier if you don't have to stop and start.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay, so now I'm going to tuck in my new weaver against some spokes.
Just tuck it in.
And
do you start where you last ended that
the weaver?
Yeah. Do you start the new one at which point do you start the new one?
Right where, so my old one died about right there.
Uh-huh.
I started the next one right next to it.
Oh,
so
right.
You want to just act like it's an exact continuation so it's balanced.
Yeah, because otherwise the pattern will also go,
right.
Has to go the same way.
Exactly. All right, so I'm gonna keep going around now. And at this point, I want my basket to turn up a little bit. And all I'm gonna do is I'm going to start just pulling inwards a little bit.
On your spokes?
Yeah, so I'm gonna want it to come in a little bit like that. And you just pull in a little bit at a time, and it kind of will naturally occur. one of the biggest mistakes when you first do basket weaving is you don't end up with a flat bottom, which is not the worst thing in the world, but you know, it's a, then the basket is a piece of art that sits on its side. And you say, I meant to do that.
So if it wobbles and doesn't sit, can you soak it so that you can then press it down into shape?
Absolutely. You can just put this whole thing in the water, come back next week. Yeah. And it's always, it's a good idea if it starts to dry out to, you can even just, like right now, I just dipped it in water, but to keep it pretty damp, because it will, it'll allow, if the reed stays wet, when it dries out, it will shrink up a lot and make a really tight surface, which is what you want.
We needed this class at the beginning of this coronavirus.
Yeah, right about a year ago.
What'd you say?
I said we needed this class about a year ago
when the
lockdown started. We'd have about 100 baskets by now.
By now, yeah. So, if, you know, as we go around, I'll tell you, you can stop about at any point. And if you had a really beautiful piece of like wisteria vine that was knotty, or a ribbon, or anything you want that you'd want to weave in, it'll, you can tuck it in and weave it as a row or two or three rows as a change from just the plain reed.
Once I get into this, I'm going to do that. Have it coordinate with your color scheme.
Yeah, coordinate. You can also dye baskets. Once you make your basket, there's all kinds of really, dyeing is a whole art unto itself, but you can just use writ dye. This dyes very, very easily. You can also dye some of your reed beforehand and use different colors.
Yeah.
All right, so you can see I'm starting to, I think you guys got this. I'm starting to curve up a little bit.
Yeah, yours is doing good, Philip.
Yeah.
That's why I brought him. He's so good at this stuff.
All right. Hold
it right there. As opposed to me. I'll get the hang of it. I used to do a lot of needlework in the old days.
We spent a summer doing this at the beach one year. That was really fun. It's a great place, great beach activity. And I just order, I used to have to get special, order my reeds at special places, but it's really, you can get it on Amazon now, of course. If you really get into it, there's some beautiful specialty shops, mostly in the Northeast, I think. But all right, so I have come around again, and I'm about out of my weaver. So I am going to tuck it down and bring it out.
Grab some.
All right. Long one.
So how long we should soak it so that we can work with it easily?
I prefer to do it overnight, but did most of you guys do yours 30 minutes?
I did mine overnight, kind of.
I just did mine, so it's very stiff.
Well, and you know, it might be you just have to feel it. I have thinner reed, so it soaked really fast, but you know, ideally it would be a few hours, but that was a guess that it would work at 30 minutes, but I guess you'll just have to kind of see.
Yeah.
Now we're gonna keep on going.
We're gonna keep on going.
Right.
And we're gonna go up probably, I don't know, an inch or two, and then I'm gonna show you how to finish the basket.
Oh, we're gonna go an inch.
Really fun.
Will you be redoing this class again?
No, but the video will be online.
Okay.
Yeah, and so, which is great. So you can go back and watch it online.
Okay.
Yeah. Is yours still not soft enough, huh?
No, it's pretty hard.
Yeah. Yeah, we tried to figure out how it's hard to let everybody know to soften ahead of time. So since we don't sign up names or anything. So I'm going up a little sharper than I want, so I'm just going to loosen it back up a little bit, pull it. You'll be amazed how good your basket will look. It's really awesome.
Yeah, we like it already.
I don't know. It looks pretty clunky right now.
Does it?
Mine does.
Well, maybe your second basket, huh?
So if you had to make just a small little basket, then you would cut shorter spokes.
You know, I probably wouldn't go any shorter than 2 feet because it gets pretty hard to work with when they're shorter.
I see.
So we will be cutting a lot of this off, but maybe no more, 18 inches or something. It just gets hard when they're really short.
Then you are left with some end pieces.
I'm going to show you in a minute. We'll be able to cut them and tuck them under. And so it makes a really nice edge to the basket. Yeah, because otherwise it'll just all fall apart. And there's many, many ways to actually edge a basket. And there's some beautiful, really complicated ones that I actually never mastered. So I didn't, when I learned this, there was no YouTube and I couldn't find somebody to teach me for a long time. I finally found a book that had the information in it. But
They also weave the seat of a chair, you know?
Oh yeah, you can absolutely do that. Yeah, it's a little bit of a different process because you don't have a center.
It's a frame.
It's a frame, exactly.
And they make a design. They make a design for the seat. Yeah.
I've actually done, and I've actually caned with this here too. A wooden chair that has a caning seat often will have holes drilled in the frame.
Yeah.
You just weave it's like a warp and weft. You weave one direction, then you for the spokes, and then weave the other. All right, so I'm going to end. Let's end our basket here.
Uh-huh.
I'm tucking in my last end. So when you get to your weaver, the last weaver, go ahead and stop. This will be a little basket.
Want me to cut it so you know?
And you can kind of move them around a little bit for a while and tighten them up and arrange them and they squinch a little bit.
Well, we could cut it. You've got a ton left here. You've got a long weaver.
Now, I'm weaving, but then the things are slipping around.
Your spokes are turning the other way?
Yeah. I don't know if you can see that.
Which part is turning around? The spokes themselves are turning out?
Yeah. They're kind of, I think it's, I'm not doing it at the right pressure or something.
Yeah, that just takes practice. And you, when you weave, you'll kind of pull a little bit inward or outward and downward. I should have said that to you. If you pull a little bit downward, it keeps it tight too. Also, you guys dip your spokes right now in water again in your basket because mine's already drying out. Mine's thinner.
Yeah.
Make sure they keep it pretty wet.
Okay.
We don't have enough water. The reeds keep soaking up our water.
Yeah, you should put it under the faucet too if you need to.
Getting water all over the floor.
Yep.
Phillips looks really good. I'm glad I brought him.
Oh, yeah. Nice to have that support there.
That way, when I try and make it, he can show me how to do it. I'll look on the, if it's online, I'll make one. And I'm going to do it on the deck.
I think
that would be better. We're on tile, it doesn't matter if it gets wet.
Okay, now what?
Okay, we're ready.
And we're gonna wait till everybody's finished with their last weaver.
Okay, we could be
so keep it, yeah, keep it wet in the meantime.
Sticking out.
She's gonna show you how to do it.
Okay.
And if not, I could get a crochet hook and stick them in there.
Oh yeah, pokey tools. That's what my daughter calls them, pokey tools. She's got things you can poke in there with. Have lots of different pokey tools.
From knitting and crocheting in the old days, I know how to get rid of loose ends.
Yeah.
That's the best.
Yeah. That's a nice one too, and we'll put it under water, it'll tighten up. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe a little loose.
Deborah, how's it going now?
Okay, I guess. I'm trying to get the end of a thing in.
Okay.
Poke an end in and see if I can get that.
Okay.
No, say it's too loose. Say that's how you intended it.
A lot of it's just practice, too.
Yeah, you did a great job, I think. And I'm the only one you have to please, so there you have it.
Nice. It's good. Natural born weaver over there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yours is lovely, Barbara.
He is. I'm kind of uncoordinated. It'll take me a lot more practice, so.
Well, if you can crochet and knit, you pick it up pretty fast.
Yeah. I used to, like, I used to crochet a lot.
Soak it.
Yeah, soak it, it's getting dried out.
Because she's kind of flattened out.
Maria,
you're using, it's a number two, these are number three cane.
Those are number three.
This is the number three?
Uh-huh.
This is not hard. Mm-hmm. You're not looking at a book, you know.
How's it going, Maria?
You don't have to wait for me. I'll just listen and do it.
Oh, not everybody's done, so. Me, are you finished with your last weaver? Yeah. Oh, look, a nice, yeah, look at that. That's a potter for you.
How did that happen? You were so flat there.
Well, no, she was saying that.
Oh, it happened.
Sometimes you gotta, yeah.
So,
okay.
She's like,
I'll go ahead and start how to demonstrate, and I wrote this out really carefully, but to seal, just, You're basically going to weave back down the edges to lock them down. So I'm going to take one pair of spokes right here. I'm going to go into the middle of the basket behind the next spoke right here and go over this one. And when I go over this one, fold it under to the inside of the next spoke and pull it down to the outside. Okay, so I went under the next one with both spokes, and I'm just gonna weave it, basically poke it down two or three weavers, layers.
You go over first and then under?
Go around, basically you take your spoke and you go to the inside of the next spoke to the right.
To the right. Get it to the left.
Yeah, or to the left, yeah. That's fine. And then before you get to yet the next spoke, right before it, I'm gonna weave it down, weave both of them down and pull down. So my basket's gonna start looking like this. It's got loops and the loop goes under the next spoke.
How many do you go under with your spoke?
I do two or three, just enough. What's going to happen is we're going to cut this off later and tuck them in a little bit. So it's not totally crucial. This is the first round. So each pair is going to go behind its neighbor. And then
behind the neighbor.
And then tuck in at some point and pull out and down.
Okay.
Inside, down.
And then she just sticks them under.
Any questions on that? How do you feel it?
Hey, maybe I don't want to get rid of the bathtub.
Yes.
It's almost like an overstitch, I guess.
Although you'll have your bathtub.
Down. Yeah. Okay. Got a strange.
Yeah, kind of loosening up.
Yeah, you could probably.
There you go.
Yeah, it's okay if it doesn't go all the way around. That's what she said.
Don't forget, ours are not very flexible.
Now, I made a mistake, but all I'm going to do is cheat a little bit. I missed a spoke there and just go down at some point where it looks pretty good. Take my two double weavers down.
Oh, yeah, I missed a spoke also. Okay, the spoke that you go behind is the next spoke that you do.
Right, yeah.
Okay.
It's all right, it won't really show. And by the time you're at the last spoke, you're gonna weave, let's see.
There.
Weave under.
Oh, look at you. She's getting a really nice edge.
So when you get to the very last one and your first spoke is already woven down, you'll just pretend it's up a little bit and do the same thing. That's really hard to describe. You'll weave behind it and through it. When you get there, let me know. You'll probably figure it out, but if not, let me know.
Yeah, I'm on the last. I missed one too.
Well, you know what? Maybe it's, I didn't think I did, but maybe there's a trick to that, but I don't know. I don't remember. So just go ahead and leave it down.
Actually, I'm gonna go back.
Okay, there's the next spoke, yeah.
So when you're done, did you get yours done, B?
Okay, I go right here, yeah.
Yeah. You're muted.
I wanna make mine taller.
Taller, so you're gonna wait, okay. Yeah, I did a really nice shape, literally in the 70s, that was an hourglass, and I put a piece of bamboo in it as a stopper.
Yeah, I'm hanging mine.
Yeah.
Send it over, Barb. Yeah, I'm taking photographs of the screen, screenshots.
That's so a good way to do it.
Remember what you're doing. I can always watch the video later too, but.
Yeah. It's kind of hard to read instructions about basket weaving.
That's true.
Now, so this is one way you can do it. There's also ways you can just kind of keep weaving your spokes around. You can just try and figure an even pattern you like. You'll see some baskets that they've taken a whole nother piece of cane and just wrapped it really tightly all the way around the edge. There's the world is your oyster.
It's as good as it's going to get, Mel.
Yeah. So once you've got, while you finish that, let me see if I have that other basket.
This is a little tighter, I guess. But yeah. Art, you know, we can't do it because ours is too stiff. No. The next one we make will be better.
Yeah.
I think it's good though.
I don't have it.
There. Okay.
See?
Yeah.
Oh. Now at this point, you can actually just cut off the extra spokes and cut them very close.
Okay.
And get the super glue out, eh?
Yeah. Oh, no. You can also weave them in again if you want, but I didn't do it on this one.
Next time.
And there's your basket.
And yet, it will
stick. Work it to where you like the shape, and then you'll let it dry.
I'm going to put mine in the sink.
Look at that. That's awesome. I kind of like Deborah, I like your open loops. You could keep that if you wanted. You just got to weave the other stuff. Yeah, just leave it up. Yeah. Yeah, look at yours. That's great. Awesome.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yours turned out nice. That looks really good.
Yeah, beautiful. Now, if you start doing a lot bigger baskets, at some point, you're going to have too much space between your ribs as they go further and further out. You can actually start inserting new spokes in if you want to go big. Yeah. This basket, you can see very primitive. Somebody did a bottom first and a cane. And they did two and two.
I'm going to put it in the sink.
And then they did some grapevine as the top. That's two materials in one, which is kind of awesome. And they did a decorative kind of thing around it. So you can actually do anything you want. It's really awesome to do this.
Oh, I really enjoyed that. It was very restful.
It is restful. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, Gloria, did you get? I know Gloria's trying to work at the same time, so